You've just downloaded Procreate and not sure where to start? In this beginner tutorial, I will guide you through the Procreate interface step by step. You will learn how to organize your artwork in the gallery, how to create and manage groups, and even how to customize your workspace, like moving the sidebar or switching between light and dark mode. By the end of this video, you will feel comfortable navigating Procreate and ready to start creating your own drawings. Let's get started. Procreate has two main interfaces, the gallery interface and the canvas interface. In this tutorial, let's walk through both of them, starting with the gallery interface. When you open Procreate, the very first screen we see is the gallery interface. This is where all of our past artworks are saved as original project files. What you're looking at on the screen right now are the thumbnails, little previews of each project file. Below each thumbnail, you will see two lines of text. The first line is the file name. If you tap on it, you can rename the file to whatever you like. The second line shows the canvas dimensions for that project. However, the canvas size can't be changed here in the gallery interface. Now let's take a look at the four buttons in the top right corner of the gallery interface. We will start with the very first one, the Select button. When we tap Select, you will notice that a little checkbox appears in front of each project file. At the same time, the buttons in the top right corners also change. Now we can choose one or multiple project files at once. If we only choose a single file, the first button in the top right, the stack button, will stay gray and uneditable. But as soon as we select two or more files, the stack button becomes active. For example, here I will select two project files from my membership tutorials. Now let's tap stack. You will see that the files we selected are grouped together into one stack. In other words, a stack is basically just a folder or group for organizing your files. So now I've grouped my two tutorial demo files together into one folder. Next, let's return to the main gallery view. The stack we just created can also be renamed. Since mine contains two level 2 membership tutorial demos, I'm going to rename this stack to level 2 tutorial demos. If we open this stack, you will see each project file inside with its thumbnail, name, and canvas size, just like before. So how do we move a file out of this stack? It's really simple. Just tap and hold on a file, then drag it up to the top left corner of the screen, hold it there for about 2 seconds, and then the file will pop out of the stack. Repeat this process, and you can move all of your grouped file back out into the main gallery. Next, let's take a look at the other buttons. The Share button lets us export the selected file in different image formats. The Duplicate button creates a copy of the selected file, and then the Delete button permanently deletes the file. Now, be very careful with the Delete button. This action cannot be undone. Once a file is deleted, there's no way to bring it back. Personally, I usually make sure I've already airdropped the file to my MacBook before I delete it. Since we just duplicated a file a moment ago, I will go ahead and delete that exact copy now. Finally, let's tap the Close button in the top right corner to return to the main gallery view. Now let's go over the rest of the buttons in the top right corner. The Import button allows us to bring in other project files. The Photos buttons let us open image directly from our photo library. And finally, the Plus button is for creating a new canvas. When we tap the New Canvas button, a panel will appear. Here, Procreate provides several common canvas sizes, such as A4 paper or screen size. If we want to create a canvas with a custom size, we can tap the Custom Canvas button right next to it. This opens a panel where we can set the canvas width, height, and resolution exactly as we need. So how do we move from the gallery interface into the canvas interface? There are two ways: create a new canvas or open any existing project file. For now, let's use the second method and open one of our files. Once we enter the canvas interface, you will notice that there are more buttons here compared to the gallery. Let's take a look at what each of them does, starting with the five main buttons in the top left corner of the screen. We will quickly go through these buttons one by one. Later in tutorial 1.4 series, we will do some simple practice drawings with small objects, and I will show you how to actually use these buttons step by step as we draw together. The first button is the gallery button. This links back to the gallery interface. Tap it once and you will return to the gallery. Tap on your project file again and you will come back to the canvas. The second button is Actions button. Inside, you will find lots of useful tools. Some of the ones we use most often are inserting photos, cropping and resizing the canvas, and exporting your work in different file formats. The third button is Adjustments button, which includes a variety of smart tools for editing and enhancing your image. The fourth button is a Selections button, which allows you to create selections in many different ways. And finally, the fifth button is a Transform button. These let you move, resize, and transform your artwork. Next, let's take a look at the buttons in the top right corner of the canvas interface. These are the tools we will be using most often while drawing. The first tool is a brush tool. Tap these and you can choose from many different types of brushes to draw with. The second tool is the smudge tool. This is used to soften or blend colors on your canvas. Just like the brush tool, you can also change which brush the smudge tool uses. The third tool is the eraser tool. This one is simple, it erases whatever you've drawn. The fourth button is a layer panel. You can think of layers like separate sheets of drawing papers stacked on top of each other. And the fifth button is a color panel, also known as the color picker. This is where you select and manage the colors for your artwork. Now let's take a look at the sidebar on the left side of the screen. The sidebar also has five tools. The first and third tools are sliders. The top slider controls your brush size. Slide it up to make the brush larger or down to make it smaller. The bottom slider controls your brush opacity. Slide it down to lower the opacity and make your strokes more transparent, or slide it up to make them more solid. In the middle, you will see a rounded square button. This is the modify button. You can customize this button as a shortcut for any tool or option you use often. And finally, at the bottom, there are two curved arrows. The arrow pointing left is the undo button, which lets you undo your last action. Procreate can undo up to 250 steps. The arrow pointing right is the redo button, which brings back any stroke you just undid. Right now, you'll notice that the Procreate background is set to light mode, and the sidebar is on the left side of the screen. But actually, both the background color and the sidebar position can be customized. To adjust these, tap the Actions button, then go to Preferences. Under Preferences, you will see two options. Light Interface. This controls the background color of the app. When it's turned on, the interface switches to a light background. When it's turned off, the interface switches to a dark mode. Right-hand Interface. This controls the position of the sidebar. When it's on, the sidebar will move to the right side of the screen. The sidebar can also be moved up or down on the screen. To do this, tap and hold on the Modify button in the middle of the sidebar, then drag it toward the center of the screen. This will lift up the whole sidebar so you can slide it into a new position. Sometimes it takes a couple of tries, especially if your screen is smooth and it doesn't register right away. But once you've lifted it, you can move it up or down to wherever feels comfortable. Release your finger and then the sidebar will stay fixed in that new spot. So go ahead and customize your interface based on your own habits and what feels most natural for you. That's it for this Procreate interface tutorial. In the following tutorials, we will cover basic gesture controls and do some quick draw together to practice. If you want more beginner projects right now, check out my tutorials on drawing a potted plant or a cute cat portrait. Perfect for getting hands-on. And if you like to go further, I also have a Patreon-style membership program with many real-time drawing tutorials. In those lessons, I draw and explain step-by-step with no speeding up, so you can follow along at your own pace. My goal is to help beginners build a regular drawing habit and feel a sense of achievement with every practice. Too often, beginners practice on their own, end up unhappy with the result, and lose the courage to keep going. I want my tutorials to be the opposite, something you can pick up anytime, follow along, and enjoy creating. The more time you spend drawing, the more your skills will grow. And I love to guide you on that journey. So if that sounds helpful, check out the membership. I'd be so happy to draw together with you there. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in my next tutorial. Bye-bye.